وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to another episode of Quran Circle 6, and we are in the 12th juz in Surah Hud, and at the end inshallah ta'ala we'll start Surah Yusuf. And in this juz inshallah ta'ala we'll look at the verses that kind of related to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us truly follow the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. It's very important to look into the verses of the Quran from many different perspectives. And the Quran is like a treasure that never ceases to bring its jewelry and goodness and lights and things like this. It never ceases whatsoever. The more the person gain knowledge, the more that you would extract benefits from the Quran. It's a book that is amazing. The more you read it with knowledge, the more that you would get benefits from it. Imam Malik rahimahullah, they used to be amazed of how much he extract benefits from the Quran. So they asked his sister, what does he do? You know, how does he reach this level of extracting benefits from the Quran? She said to them that once he enters his home, he has nothing else that makes him busy except the Quran. And you add to this the knowledge of someone like Imam Malik. So this is, we need to keep on seeking knowledge and extracting benefits from the Quran. So we're looking at that one specific subject, which is the Prophet ﷺ in the Quran. We'll start inshallah ta'ala by introducing the reciters, and then we'll listen to some of the recitations so that we can benefit inshallah ta'ala also from their recitation. We have with us Sheikh Asad Al-Hawi from Egypt. Welcome to the program.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Sheikh Karim Saudi from Egypt.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Sheikh Jamil Hassan from Nigeria. Barakallahu feek. Welcome to the program. Sheikh Ahmad Rajab from Egypt. Welcome to the program. Barakallahu feek. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy and give us all sincerity inshallah ta'ala. Inshallah we'll start with the beginning of Surah Hud. And I ask myself and everyone to listen attentively and even follow the verses. We have the Masahif opened, then the Mus'haf, and open it and follow the recitation inshallah ta'ala, and try to perfect the recitation. We'll start inshallah ta'ala from the beginning of Surah Hud, from the first ayah till ayah number 7. And Sheikh Asad, please go ahead inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام را. كتاب أحكمت آياته ثم فصلت من لدن حكيم خبير. ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إنني لكم منه نذير وبشير. وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يمتعكم متاعا حسنا إلى أجل مسمى ويؤتي كل ذي فضل فضله. وإن تولوا فإني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم كبير. إلى الله مرجعكم وهو على كل شيء قدير. ألا إنهم يثنون صدورهم ليستخفوا منه. ألا حين يستغشون ثيابهم يعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون. إنه عليم ذات الصدور. وما من دار الأرض إلا على الله رزقها ويعلم مستقرها ومستودعها كل في كتاب مبين. وهو الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام وكان عرشه على الماء خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام وكان عرشه على الماء ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. ولئن قلت إنكم مبعوثون من بعد الموت ليقولن الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا سحر مبين.
بارك الله فيك، جزاك الله خيرا. سورة هود، the prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said about it شيبتني هود وأخواتها. That the surah of Hud gave gray hair to the Prophet ﷺ, gave him gray hair because of what's in it. And that's why this is one of the things that we need to reflect upon, how the Prophet ﷺ used to be affected by the Quran that is revealed to him. And he is someone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him, and he is given the highest level in Jannah. And still how the effect of the surah to the Prophet ﷺ, that it gave him the gray hair alayhi salatu wasalam. In the beginning of the surah, as we hear, it praises the Quran as usual with the long surahs that starts with the letters Alif Lam Ra or Alif Lam Mim or the like of this, and how the Quran is mentioned first, and how this Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is made so clear for people to see the truth, and therefore they need to adopt and hold fast to the truth, and that is not to worship anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet ﷺ to say, إِنَّنِي لَكُم مِّنْهُ نَذِيرٌ وَبَشِيرٌ. Indeed, I am to you from him a warner and bashir, someone that gives glad tidings. That the Prophet ﷺ is to the people from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet ﷺ to warn the people and to give glad tidings. Warning and glad tidings. Warning from the hellfire, from the punishment of Allah. For those who disbelieve in him, for those who disobey him, turn away from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, live heedlessly in this life. And glad tidings for those who understand the purpose of their life, those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who worship him and seek forgiveness from him. And that's why the next verse, وَأَنِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Seek forgiveness from your Lord, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will give you an enjoyment in this life to a specific limit. This is how we live on the face of earth, for a limited time. And he would give to whoever he will subhanahu wa ta'ala from his bounty. And if they turn away from the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ كَبِيرٍ. I indeed fear for you a major punishment in a major day. So this is what the Prophet ﷺ would convey to the people. And this is how those who have concern to humanity, they do. They don't deceive them. They don't just say things that it does not really matter to them, but rather to warn them, to give them the glad tidings. And it's all about matters of the hereafter. And people would live on the face of earth and enjoy whatever they enjoy. And everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the core of the da'wah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. To Allah, you all shall return. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do all things. They believe in the hereafter. And then establishing some of the meanings of the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. And all of the walking creatures and everything, all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider for it. And He knows how it's initiated and how it ends. And everything is written and everything is recorded. And everything shows the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, and the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on top of the water, as we heard in the verses. All of that is for what? To test you who among you are the best in actions. And if you say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you will be resurrected after death, the disbelievers, they would say this is a clear magic or sorcery. And this is how they their hearts become sealed from seeing the truth, and they deny the fitrah, the nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in them. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses from Surah Hud and from verses number 9 to 14. And Sheikh Kareem, go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. ولئن أذقنا الإنسان منا رحمة ثم نزعناها منه إنه ليئوس كفور ولئن أذقناه نعماء بعد ضراء مسته ليقولن ذهب السيئات عني إنه لفرح فخور إلا الذين صبروا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير فلعلك تارك بعض ما يوحى إليك وضائق به صدرك أن يقولوا لولا أنزل عليه كنز أو جاء معه ملك إنما أنت نذير والله على كل شيء وكيل أم يقولون افتراه قل فأتوا بعشر سور مثله مفتريات وادعوا من استطعتم فإن لم يستجيبوا لكم فاعلموا أنما أنزل بعلم الله وأن لا إله إلا هو فهل أنتم مسلمون.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. As we heard these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is stating how the human beings they act when they are lacking the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They give up, they are in disparity, they are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they receive something from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then it's taken away from them. Why? Because of how the nature of the human beings, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his favor upon the believers, when they are always grateful to Allah and they're between being grateful or being patient with the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the like of this, as it's mentioned, if something good happens to them after difficulty or hardship, they would say, or they would become forgetful, and they forget that they have faced trials before. And this is how the human beings, they go back and forth from these types of maybe feelings or emotions or actions. But for the believers, the matter is different. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet والسلام, accept those who have patience and they do righteous good deeds. So those who have patience, they're not going back and forth like this between forgetfulness and having bad thinking and expectations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but rather they understand the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all. So they're patient, they do righteous good deeds, They are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them, and they receive a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Prophet ﷺ. Surah Hud, by the way, was revealed to give comfort to the Prophet ﷺ in whatever he was facing from his people by mentioning the stories of the prophets before. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet ﷺ that you might leave some of what have been revealed to you and your chest become tight when it comes to this, because they say that maybe they would suggest that a treasure would come down unto the Prophet ﷺ, part of the abuse that the disbelievers would say to the Prophet ﷺ, or bring an angel with you or something like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say to the Prophet ﷺ, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ نَذِيرٌ. Indeed, you are nothing but a warner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that disposed the affairs of everyone. And also mentioning that the disbelievers, they would say that he made up the Quran, so the challenge comes, bring the like of 10 surahs, as we know that this is mentioned differently throughout the Quran, 10 surahs the like of the Quran forged and made up. If you are able to do so, if it's something that the Prophet ﷺ made up, so why don't you make up something the like of it, or even better than this, or even a portion of it? And of course, they don't have the capacity to do it. فَإِلَّمْ يَسْتَجِيبُ لَكُمْ فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ. If they don't respond to you, then have the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it by the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there's no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Are you then submitting yourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? More of the verses that relates to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and for us to benefit from it. And verses number 15 to 19, from 15 to 19, and Sheikh Jamil, please go ahead and recite for us, inshaAllah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. من كان يريد الحياة الدنيا وزينتها نوفي إليهم أعمالهم فيها وهم فيها لا يبخسون. أولئك الذين ليس لهم في الآخرة إلا النار وحبط ما صنعوا فيها وباطل ما كانوا يعملون. أفمن كان على بينة من ربه ويتلوه شاهد منه ومن قبله كتاب موسى إماما ورحمة أولئك يؤمنون به. ومن يكفر به من الأحزاب فالنار موعده. فلا تك في مرية منه إنه الحق من ربك ولكن أكثر الناس لا يؤمنون. ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أولئك يعرضون على ربهم ويقول الأشهاد هؤلاء الذين كذبوا على ربهم ألا لعنة الله على الظالمين. الذين يصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا وهم بالآخرة هم كافرون.
بارك الله فيك. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. The verses talks about the reality of this life versus the hereafter, and those who they adorn this life and are heedless of the hereafter, they will ruin themselves and they would receive nothing but the hellfire in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is basically calling the people to take from this life what is sufficient for them as a provision for the hereafter, and to separate themselves from those who are basically taking the path of the hellfire. And those who are the believers, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are the successful ones. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make clear the verses in the Quran and the truth versus falsehood and the nations before and how they witness for the truth that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought to the people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this, the Quran, the book of Allah, the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the truth from your Lord. But most of the people, they do not believe, and there's no one of wrongdoing more than someone that would deny the truth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and they will receive the punishment in the hereafter, those who prevent people from seeing the truth. So the verses is basically preparing the reciter and of course the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to what comes afterwards, the stories that are mentioned in the surah and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the disbelievers and how he saved the believers from the punishment in this life and in hereafter, all of that to give that comfort to the heart of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. We continue inshallah ta'ala and with verses number 96 to 107 after what we should read from the stories of the surah, benefits that is basically related to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. 96 to 107, and Sheikh Ahmed, please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولقد أرسلنا موسى بآياتنا وسلطان مبين إلى فرعون وملئه فاتبعوا أمر فرعون وما أمر فرعون برشيد يقدم قومه يوم القيامة فأوردهم النار وبئس الورد المورود وأتبعوا في هذه لعنة ويوم القيامة بئس الرفد المرفود ذلك من أنباء القرى نقصه عليك ذلك من أنباء القرى نقصه عليك منها قائم وحصيد وما ظلمناهم ولكن ظلموا أنفسهم فما أغنت عنهم آلهتهم التي يدعون من دون الله من شيء وما ظلمناهم ولكن ظلموا فما أغنت عنهم آلهتهم التي يدعون من دون الله من شيء لما جاء أمر ربك وما زادوهم غير تتبيب وكذلك أخذ ربك إذا أخذ القرى وهي ظالمة إن أخذه أليم شديد إن في ذلك لآية لمن خاف عذاب الآخرة ذلك يوم مجموع له الناس وذلك يوم مشهود وما نؤخره إلا لأجل معدود يوم يأتي لا تكلم نفس إلا بإذنه فمنهم شقي وسعيد فأما الذين شقوا ففي النار لهم فيها زفير وشهيق خالدين فيها ما دامت السماوات والأرض إلا ما شاء إن ربك فعال لما يريد.
بارك الله فيك. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses talks about Prophet Musa alayhi salam very briefly as a way to mention the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth and how people with regards to their messengers, either they follow the messengers and they lead them to their salvation and they enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the enemies of Allah, like the people of Fir'aun. Fir'aun led them to their own destruction and to the hellfire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning that to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, for the ummah of the Prophet to get to see the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for the Prophet to receive that comfort facing the trials and facing the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how that the outcome is always what is best for the prophets and the followers of the prophets, and that these nations or these towns, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them because of their wrongdoing and their injustice, and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is such a severe one. And this is a sign, ayah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who fear the punishment in the hereafter. Then the verses talks about the hereafter and how the hereafter, the day of judgment, everybody will be gathered and everybody will witness, and it's delayed for a specific time by the wisdom of Allah, by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one will be given the permission to speak except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and people will be made basically two groups, those who are wretched and those who are chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people of the hellfire versus the people of the Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all from the hellfire and to make us among the people of Jannah. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses in Surah Hud and also Surah Yusuf in the 12th juz, but right after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ
رَمَضَانُ
Today we want to talk about the ways, the actual practical ways to achieve happiness, so that way we can attain that success in this dunya and in the next.
As men in particular, we are financially responsible for our families, and also we will be asked about our money. In the hadith it mentions where it came from and what we spent on. But the major sins that needs tawbah, that needs real repentance, real serious repentance.
I want to focus the majority of this episode on the major signs, as they are mainly more important, and of course they, we can relate to them and hopefully increase us in iman, which will in turn make us successful Muslims inshallah. So
the fact that Allah is telling us about Jannah and Jahannam, we should take heed so that we can wake up. The fact that Allah is telling us about the Day of Judgment, what will happen, is because when we experience it, we can't deny it.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Welcome back, and we're still in the 12th juz and Surah Hud and more other verses that is related to the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. And this time inshallah ta'ala will be from verses 108 to 113. And Sheikh Asad, please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ سُعِدُوا فَفِي الْجَنَّةِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ رَبُّكَ عَطَاءً غَيْرَ فلا تك في مرية مما يعبد هؤلاء ما يعبدون إلا كما يعبد آباؤهم من قبل وإنا لموفوهم نصيبهم غير منقوص وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ فَاخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم وإنهم لفي شك منه مريب وإن كلا لما ليوفينهم ربك أعمالهم إنه بما يعملون خبير فاستقم كما أمرت ومن تاب معك ولا تطغوا إنه بما تعملون بصير ولا تركنوا إلى الذين ظلموا فتمسكم النار ولا تركنوا إلى الذين ظلموا فتمسكم النار وما لكم من دون الله من أولياء ثم لا تنصرون
بارك الله فيك من الله سبحانه وتعالى رودي These verses has in it the verse that Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما he said that this is what caused the gray hair to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام which is فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering the Prophet to be steadfast as he has been ordered. And this is such a heavy responsibility. Even though the Prophet perfected it and he was steadfast as perfect as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him. But because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart, not to be steadfast according to what you think or what you desire, but according to what you have been ordered. When we look into the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, the order to establish the salah, for example, this is an order to establish it in the most perfect way. But we know that we are humans and we are weak and we do not fulfill really the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way it ought to be. And that's why we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But the concern in the hearts of the believers is to have that concern. Is to have that concern to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to establish the ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and or with seeking forgiveness from Allah. So this ayah فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْا And also those who repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and do not transgress the limits. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all seer of what you do, and do not rely upon those who committed ظلم and transgression. Otherwise, the fire will touch you and you won't have a protector and a helper from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the verses talks about the people of Jannah, talks about the prophets before and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the revelation and they differed among themselves as because of their own actions and their evil actions. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well acquainted of what they do. So these verses and before that are the stories that are mentioned in the surah and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed that to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This is what brought the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart, and it should by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala and the next set of verses 114 to 117. And Sheikh Kareem, go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات ذلك ذكرى للذاكرين واصبر فإن إن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين فلولا كان من القرون من قبلكم أولو بقية ينهون عن الفساد في الأرض إلا قليلا من أنجينا منهم واتبع الذين ظلموا ما أترفوا فيه وكانوا مجرمين وما كان ربك ليهلك القرى بظلم وأهلها مصلحون.
ما شاء الله جزاك الله خيرا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after he ordered him to be steadfast as he has been ordered, and also for those who repented with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to establish the salah. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ طَرَفَ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْنِ. It was said to be the five daily prayers. And the Prophet ﷺ is ordered, and the Ummah of the Prophet ﷺ is ordered. And this is something that also for us to reflect. As mentioned before, the Prophet ﷺ has been given the responsibility of al-risala, the messengership, to convey it to the people, and he conveyed it perfectly ﷺ, and also to apply it perfectly, and he applied it perfectly. We see when it comes to our own selves, when we try to apply the orders of Allah, how deficient we are. And we don't have the responsibilities that the Prophet ﷺ had. This is something for the believers to witness with their hearts, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected the Prophet ﷺ. With all of the responsibilities and the burden and the trials and facing the enemies and all of these types of things, the Prophet ﷺ fulfilled these acts of worship in the most perfect way. Establishing the salah in its time, never to delay it, to do it with the perfect khushu', with all of these different responsibilities, the Prophet ﷺ would find the comfort of his eyes and the comfort of his heart in the salah at all times. And the night prayer, the Prophet ﷺ would stand long in the night prayer till his leg, alayhi salatu wasalam, his ankle would swell, and he would say, shouldn't I be a grateful slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And indeed that the good deeds makes the bad deeds go away, expiates the bad deeds. And this is a reminder for the people, wasbir, and be patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the Prophet ﷺ to be patient, because indeed the reward of the good doers is never rendered in vain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep it for them, and they will see the outcome of it by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also saying to the Prophet ﷺ about those who enjoin good and forbid evil, and how they are the successful ones. And when nations are destroyed, those who do not enjoin the good and forbid evil will be with them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated to the Prophet sallam, as we heard at the end, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى بِظُلْمٍ وَأَهْلُهَا مُصْلِحُونَ, that your Lord, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would not destroy the towns with injustice, while their people are muslihun. They are righteous in themselves, and they also rectify others. So this is how they perfect one another. They are upon righteousness, and they enjoin good and forbid evil. If communities, if towns are upon this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not ruin them, would not destroy them, which also the understanding of it, that if people are not upon righteousness, they deserve to be destroyed. They deserve the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all. The next, inshallah ta'ala, verses 118 to 123. And Sheikh Jameel, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولو شاء ربك لجعل الناس أمة واحدة ولا يزالون مختلفين إلا من رحم ربك ولذلك خلقهم وتمت كلمة ربك لأملأن جهنم من الجنة والناس أجمعين وقل لن نقص عليك من أنباء الرسل ما نثبت به فؤادك وَكُلًّا نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَجَاءَكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقُّ وَمَوْعِظَةٌ وَذِكْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَقُلْ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ اعْمَلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ عاملون وانتظروا إنا منتظرون ولله غيب السماوات والأرض وإليه يرجع الأمر كله فاعبده وتوكل عليه وما ربك بغافل عما تعملون.
بارك الله فيك. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. And this is the end of Surah Hud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you can again imagine this is something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is receiving from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it shows the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and giving all that comfort to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the way for us to receive this comfort is to put ourselves in that same position, to receive the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking to us, because the Quran is the speech of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا, that if your Lord will subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would make all of the people just one nation, one religion, they're all faithful, but they will continue to be different. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings, except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his mercy upon. So the chosen ones are those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his mercy upon them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them for this, for that differences, for people to have that struggle between the truth and falsehood. And the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have been perfected and completed, that the hellfire will be filled with the people of disbelief and so on, and the jinn also, the jinn and the mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to the Prophet ﷺ that all of these stories that are mentioned in the surah and what comes also afterwards in Surah Yusuf, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the messengers of Allah, the stories of the messengers of Allah. For what reason? مَنْ نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, what will give your heart steadfastness and comfort in the hearts of the Prophet ﷺ, and came to you in this surah, in this Quran, the haqq, the truth, and the admonition from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the reminder for the believers. And say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to those who do not believe, اعملوا على مكانتكم إنا عاملون, warning them, do whatever you want to do, we will also act according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. And wait, because we also are waiting. And this is not to approve what they're doing of evil, but it's like when you say to someone, well, do whatever you want. If they don't listen, if they refuse to listen to the truth, then do whatever you want, you'll see the outcome of your actions. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong the unseen of the heavens and the earth, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all matters returns to him. Physically, everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and therefore the believers, they should refer all of their affairs and the matters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be steadfast according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them, not according to their own desires. So worship Allah, rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not unaware of what you do. Then after that, the beginning of Surah Yusuf. And Surah Yusuf, as we know, is the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. The majority of the surah is about this. It's part of the stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrated to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to give the steadfastness to the heart of the Prophet alayhi salam at times in Mecca, when the Prophet alayhi salam faced all kinds of difficulties and the death of Khadija radiallahu anha and the uncle of the Prophet alayhi salam. The surah was revealed to give that tranquility and that comfort in the heart of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So we would listen inshallah ta'ala to the first six verses from Surah Yusuf, and Sheikh Ahmed, go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alif lam ra. Tilka ayatul kitab. نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن
بما أوحينا
إليك هذا القرآن وإن كنت من قبله لمن الغافلين إذ قال يوسف لأبيه يا أبت إني رأيت أحد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر إذ قال يوسف لأبيه يا أبت إني رأيت أحد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر رأيتهم لي ساجدين قال يا بني لا تقصص رؤياك على إخوتك فيكيدوا لك كيدا إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين وكذلك يجتبيك ربك ويعلمك من تأويل الأحاديث ويتم نعمته عليك
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. You might say, what Surah Yusuf to do with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and it's all about Yusuf alayhi salam. First of all, as we heard, this was revealed to the Prophet sallam at difficult times. The Prophet sallam was facing difficulties in Mecca. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comforted the heart of the Prophet sallam with Surah Yusuf. And that's why it said, whoever has grief, if they recite Surah Yusuf, the grief will go away. There's no specific evidence that says this. This is not like a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. But as the people of knowledge, they say that this is something that brings the grief away when a person gets to see the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially with what Yusuf ﷺ went through from one trial to the other and the outcome. How was in his life he was well established and what his father Yaqub ﷺ also went through with difficulties and trials and the heart being attached to his son and things of that nature. It's an amazing story, of course, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the best stories ever. So that brought so much comfort to the heart of the Prophet ﷺ, and that's why it's so important for us to mention this. But also mentioned in the verses as we heard, نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ. We narrate to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of all of the stories. That's why people, they like to listen to stories. Stories are one of the deputies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It affects the hearts, it changes the hearts. And that's why young and old, everybody loves stories. And the best stories are the stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. Why? Because it gives what people need. And human beings, they tend sometimes to mention in the stories things that has no benefit to it whatsoever. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only mentioned what people need to take lessons from it, to learn from it, to act accordingly, because the matter is a repeated one. So the verses praises the Quran and praises the language of the Quran, how powerful that is and how that unite even the hearts of the people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding the Prophet ﷺ of the favor of Allah, that he was not aware of this till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the beginning of the story of Yusuf alayhi salam is mentioned with the dream of Yusuf alayhi salam and how his father Yaqub, he gave him this glad tidings of what's going to happen in his life of matters of goodness and following the ways of the prophets before Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ishaq and so on. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala next time with more of these verses that is related to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from the Quran and to follow the way the Prophet ﷺ and how he was to the Quran, reciting the Quran in the Salah and reciting the Quran and outside of the Salah and reflecting upon the meanings of it and explaining the meanings of it and acting according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before we end, I would like to thank the reciters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. make it in the balance of your good deeds. And I hope this was benefiting, and for you to learn how to recite in the perfect way, and also to reflect upon the subject, which is the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So till next time, I leave you with the protection of Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إلا مبشرا.